Hello, welcome to this video on factoring trinomials of the form x squared plus bx plus c. An example of a trinomial like this is x squared plus 8x plus 15. Let's go ahead and factor this trinomial. When we factor a trinomial, we want to break the trinomial into two expressions that when multiplied together gives you the original trinomial. Each of these expressions is a factor of the original trinomial, and they help you find solutions to equations. When we factor a trinomial, we are going to use a process that is the reverse of the FOIL method. So we're going to start by writing two sets of parentheses, just like this. Now we consider the first term, x squared. What two things multiply together to get x squared? Well, x times x equals x squared, so x will be the first term in both sets of parentheses. Then we need to find two numbers that multiply together to the third term, 15, and that add to the second term, 8. So we know that 3 times 5 is equal to 15, and 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. So our two numbers will be 3 and 5. So we're going to write 3 in one set of parentheses and 5 in the other. And since we have plus signs in both places, we're going to write plus 3 and plus 5. Remember, factoring a trinomial is like unfoiling it. So if we apply the FOIL method to this new expression, we should get our original trinomial. So let's do that now to check our work. So if we FOIL this, we'll have first is x times x, which is x squared, plus outer x times 5 is 5x, and then inner is 3 times x, which is 3x, so plus 3x, and then last is 3 times 5, which is 15, so plus 15. Then we can combine our 5x and 3x and get x squared plus 8x plus 15, which is exactly what our original expression was, so that means we factored this correctly. Let's try another one. Factor the trinomial x squared plus 2x minus 63. First, we're going to set up two sets of parentheses. Then we're going to determine what two things multiply to x squared. If the coefficient of x squared is 1, like all the examples will be in this video, it is always going to be x times x. So let's go ahead and write an x in each set of parentheses. Now we need to find two numbers that multiply to negative 63 and add to 2. So let's consider the factors of 63. We have 1 times 63, 3 times 21, and 7 times 9. Now, since our product is negative, we know that one of the factors will be positive and one will be negative. So we need to consider which two factors, remember, one being a positive number and one being a negative number, will add to 2. So the two factors must be 7 and 9, and the 7 needs to be negative, because negative 7 plus 9 is equal to 2. So we're going to write minus 7 in one set of parentheses and plus 9 in the other. Again, if we FOIL this out to check our answer, we will get our original expression, which means that we factored correctly. Before we go, let's try one more example together. Factor the trinomial x squared minus 13x plus 22. First, set up the parentheses. Then put the x's where they belong, since x times x is x squared. Finally, we need to find two numbers that multiply to 22 and add to negative 13. Since the two numbers add to a negative number but multiply to a positive number, both numbers will have to be negative. So let's consider the factors of 22. We have 1 times 22 and 2 times 11. So which set of factors, when both numbers are negative, add to negative 13? The only option is negative 2 and negative 11. So we're going to write minus 2 in one set of parentheses and minus 11 in the other set. We can FOIL this out again and we'll get x squared minus 13x plus 22. So that means that our factored form, x minus 2 times x minus 11, is correct. Now there is one thing to note before we go. In the examples in this video, our trinomials factored out nicely. This isn't possible for every single trinomial. And when you come across things like that, there are other options like completing the square or using the quadratic formula to solve. However, when you are asked to factor trinomials of this form, you'll know how to do it. So I hope this video on factoring trinomials of the form x2+bx+c was helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.